अस्सलाम वालेकुम, हाउ आर यू ऑल डियर। वेलकम बैक टू आवर ऑनलाइन क्लास। होप यू आर स्टडीइंग वेल, इजंट इट? वी फिनिश्ड 3 यूनिट्स, राइट? कंप्लीट योर क्लास वर्क्स। आई एम सेंडिंग यू नोट्स रेगुलरली, इजंट इट? फर्स्ट लेसन इज फिनिश्ड, सेकंड लेसन, सेकंड यूनिट आई हैव सेंड ऑल द नोट्स पीडीएफ्स, राइट? ऑल ऑफ यू डिड नॉट सेंड मी फॉर करेक्शन, आई डोंट नो व्हाई। So now we'll start our fourth unit, B poem. This is Preteen Protects. From A part we'll see the letter. Mary is a girl studying in class 8th. Read the following letter that she wrote to her friend Candy. This is an old format. So this Wonderland Computer Town, 20th September, should come on this side, left side. This is on wrong side. You correct it, put it on this side. Okay, all of you? Are you listening? Dear Candy, I am very glad to say that I have established a computer teaching lab, which gives me full information with the help of mechanical teacher. It's an up-to-date lab. Now, one of the friend Mary's is communicating with her friend Candy. She's giving her the information that she has started something new. Her achievement, she's sharing with happiness that she has started her computer teaching lab. It's an up-to-date lab. Technology is growing fast, isn't it? Imagine your classroom in 30 years. Reply soon. With warm regards, your loving friend, Mary. To Candy, Winterland Technical Country. Mary is writing this letter to Candy, isn't it? Now, she wants some feedback. Congrats and all. Now, imagine if you have to write the letter, will you be able to write, children? Okay? Then, B part of this lesson, fourth unit, is the poem Preteen Protects, related to mobile phones. Everyone have mobile phones. Nowadays it's very, very necessary, isn't it? Even IMA has, our servants have smartphone. I have seen basic small model, isn't it? But everyone has smartphone. It's part of our life, parts of our body it have become. Let's start the poem Preteen Protects. My teeny booper has a phone, as little fellow means, a boy or a girl small. She really never is alone. It beeps and jitters day and night, emitting tiny bluish light. No one is alone nowadays, isn't it? If there is no one at home also, if you have mobile, it's more than enough. Her ringtone is at the latest rage as other preteens text and page. One eyeliner messages appear that makes her grin from year to year. The latest crisis, who likes whom? The rock star with the best perfume. Such weight matters cause her thrill and elevate our monthly bill. The routine she's trying to explain here, the monthly bill which we get. All children are always on ringtones, mobiles, new ringtones. Isn't it? Every time some new music, some new fun on it, game or something. Educational apps also there, but we don't use it, isn't it? Byju's, Happy, An Academy, good things, bad things, everything nowadays children are learning from this idiot box or good box, useful box. How you are using, you can call it, or an instrument, a mobile, just ring or phone your friends and or call them. And yet, what happens? The silver lining glows, for we have never come to blows. I never have to raise my voice. And yet the silver lining glows, for we have never come to blows. I never have to raise my voice, because I have a high-tech choice. High technology I have. So by phone, the mother calls her daughter and talks and calls from in the same room also. We are always on the phone, no? At least chatting with each other or checking something out, some important message, some right prank, some TikTok, something or the other. But we are always busy on mobiles. All age people, not that only young, you all, old people playing games. Servant is doing her work. Everyone is some, if you have knowledge, if you are educated person, you put your timetable, ringer, buzzer on a alarm clocks, isn't it? School assignments, class works, timings. If school assignments pile sky high, I exhale with a weighty sigh. Like every modern mom who cares, I simply telephone upstairs. Okay? When cores demand her energies, I simply text her asking please, no alibis or missing words. A mother is calling her daughter in such a way. So children, no alibis or missing words, no words are missing in between, because it's clear that she has heard. And if my daughter goes outside to visit friends both far and wide, her curfew is easy to enforce with her new cellular resource. She'll call from there. Her mother will come to know about it. Curfew means there's no noise in the home then, but still she keeps on reminding, calling her mother and keeping aware that she's here, she's going to visit her friend coming at night this time. There's a cellular resource. It's not a bad boom. It is a use for good information. It is a good thing for you all also. Or it is a curse for parents. Always playing on games and missing studies, missing good knowledge and all. Then it is a worse enemy of children itself. Now here it is for good thing. So it is used, the term given to mobile is new cellular resource. Got it. This beeping teether holds her close while helping her feel grandiose. If separation error occurs, but my speed dial links my heart to hers. Got it? If mother feels missing her or far away, speed dial, she dials her quickly. Our handy cell phones help us out, isn't it? They are very useful nowadays. Convenient, easy, with no doubt. Wherever you are in America, America, US, Australia, there's IMO call where we can see each other, video call, chatting, emojis, every information, counseling about your exams, education, schools, okay, NDTV, news, everything we are getting on this cellular resource. But yes, certainly, they have their place. But can't we talk once face to face? She wants to talk, mother misses her, so she wants to talk to her daughter face to face. This finishes the poem here. And now we are starting the C reading of 4th unit, the computer game. Who all are in this lesson? Characters: Gary Lopez, television game host; John Robinson, MTV, MT2, a computer; first noisemaker, second noisemaker. A boy and a girl from the audience. What is the scene, children, now? See, the two people are talking here. A television studio. Gary Lopez, name of a person. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. The announcement is made by her. Welcome to the computer game today. Another human player gets a chance to watch, gets a chance to match with our very own computer, M2. M2 blinks its light and the studio audience claps loudly. Okay, all of our good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is a computer game which is going to start. Introduction, this is Gary Lopez. Today's player is John Robinson from the Oak Street School. Feeling smart, John? John, ready? Are you ready? Gary Lopez, I hope so. May I remind you, no one has beaten MT2 yet. Now, here's how we play the game. I'll ask a question to the first player to sound a noisemaker and give the correct answer scores 1 point. The first player to earn 3 points wins the game. Ready, players? John, ready. MT2 in flat voice. I am prepared to play. Okay. Ready, Gary Lopez? I hope so. May I remind you, no one has beaten MT2 yet. Now here's how we play the game. I'll ask a question. The first player to sound a noisemaker and give the correct answer scores 1 point. Okay? We explain each other when we start a game, before we start a game, isn't it? The first player to earn 3 points wins the game. Ready? Players, John, ready. MT2 in flat voice. I am prepared to play. Gary Lopez. First question. How much is 62,415 times 7921. First noisemaker, bleep, MT2. The correct answer is 495-2585-4215. Gary Lopez, right. 1 point for the computer. Computer gives answer very quickly. MT2 is a computer. The audience claps politely. Next question. Listen carefully. What date in history did the pilgrim land at Plymouth Rock? Second noisemaker, buzz. John, 1620. Gary Lopez, I'm so sorry. Okay. That's not an exact enough answer. First noisemaker, bleep. MT2, the pilgrim landed at Plymouth Rock on December 21st. Okay, now we'll continue the lesson. Tomorrow, we'll see the two types of letters which we studied today in the starting of our class. The letters are of two types, children. Formal letter, informal letter. See the format. Formal letter, we write to the editor, newspaper, magazine, director, to our principal. That is formal. Informal, to a friend calling, to a birthday party, to a occasion, some wedding. There are two types of formal letters here. We write the date, address, everything on the left side. Dear Priyanka, we have much pleasure to invite you on the 21st birthday party. Okay, we are organizing for our son Rahul at 6:30 p.m. You can change the date and time and address. No problem. But the letter pattern should be, every step has marks, children. Address, 5 marks. Dear Priyanka, 1 mark something. Body of the letter, conclusion of the letter. Salutation means yours sincerely means salutation. Okay? Are you seeing commas, full stop, everything should be properly. Now, second letter is also here. Dear Mohan, I am in good health. So, it's also birthday party. Is it clear? 27 Apple Orchard, comma should be there. Mangalore, comma, November, full stop. Dear Priyanka, comma, yours sincerely, comma, the name. Now, this is the homework for today. Complete it and send me by evening. Write a formal letter to your friend inviting him or her to your birthday party on 15th September. Okay? All the best. Study well. Send me your homeworks. Don't forget, all of you. Thank you. See you in next class.